So this is called the first component or the principal component, and this is called the second or second principal component of this space. Okay? Does that make sense?
Yep.
Now, here's what's interesting about principal components analysis. You might ask me exactly how you do this. There are several mechanisms for doing it. For those of you who have dealt with linear algebra before, something like this singular value decomposition might be familiar to you. It's one way of finding the principal components. But principal components analysis basically has a lot of really neat properties. So let me just describe some of those properties to you. The first property is, well, the two that I've written here. It finds directions that maximize variance, and it finds directions that are mutually orthogonal. Mutually orthogonal means it's a global algorithm. And by global here, I mean that all of the directions, all of the new features that they find have a big global constraint, namely that they must be mutually orthogonal. It also turns out that you can prove, which I will try to give you a little bit of evidence for, but I'm not going to prove formally, that the PCA actually gives you the best reconstruction. Now, what do I mean by best reconstruction? Well, what I mean is if you think of each of these directions that it found, in this case, it found this one first and found this one second, the first thing I hope you see is that if I return these two dimensions, I have actually lost no information. That is, this is just a linear rotation of the original dimensions. So if I were to give you back these two different features, you could reconstruct all of your original data. You see that?
Wait, when you say features, you mean what we're going to give it is for each of those little black data points, we're going to say how far along the red axis is it and how far along the orange axis is it.
Right.
So it really is just a kind of a relabeling of the dimensions.
Right. So just like when I think about these points in X and Y space, the original feature space, whenever I give you a value here for this feature, I'm just describing how far along a black dot is on this dimension or this projection. And the second dimension or the second feature just tells me how far along a dot is on this particular dimension or axis. And similarly, by projecting onto red and onto orange, I'm telling you how far along a point is along this axis and along that axis. So if I were to take X and Y and transform them into this new 1 and 2, I would have given you different values than I'd get from X or Y, but they're actually just the same point. And so I've thrown away no information.
So that's a pretty good reconstruction.
That's a pretty good reconstruction. But what principal components analysis does for you is if I take just one of these dimensions, in particular the first one, the principal component, I am guaranteed that if I project only into this space and then try to reproject into the original space, I will minimize what's called L2 error. So do you understand that?
I'm not sure. Let me think. So you're saying if we instead of, all right, we take the little black dots, they now have a red dimension and an orange dimension, one and two. And now if we reconstruct using only the first dimension, I guess it just puts the black dots on the red line.
Yep.
And so there is no, they have no existence in that second dimension.
Correct.
And now you're saying of all the different ways that I could do that, to kind of project it to a linear sequence, this is the one that's going to have the smallest L2 error, which, if I'm not mistaken, is the same kind of reconstruction error we talked about in all the other times we talked about reconstruction. So it's like squared error.
That's exactly right. It's squared error. This particular notion is called the Frobenius norm, but that's really just talking about distance. What this means is that if I project onto this single axis here, and then I compare it to where it was in the original space, the distance, the sum of all the distances between those points, will actually be the minimal that I could get for any other projection.
Cool.
And you can sort of prove this. It kind of makes sense if you just think about the fact that points always start out in some orthogonal space, and I'm basically finding a scaling and a rotation such that I don't lose any information, and I maximize variance along the way. By maximizing variance, it turns out I'm maximizing or maintaining distances as best I can in any given dimension. And so that gives me the best reconstruction that I can imagine. Now, you might ask yourself, is there anything else nice about principal components analysis given this reconstruction error? And there's another property of PCA that is very, very useful. And it boils down to the fact that it's an eigenproblem. What happens when you do principal components analysis is you get all of these axes back. And in fact, if you start out with n dimensions, you get back n dimensions again. And the job here for a feature transformation, as you might recall, is you want to pick a subset m of them, hopefully much smaller than n. Well, it turns out that associated with each one of these new dimensions that we get is its eigenvalue. That eigenvalue is guaranteed to be non-negative. It has a lot of other neat properties. But what matters to us here is that the eigenvalues monotonically non-increase. That is, they tend to get smaller as you move from the principal to the second principal to the third to the fourth to the fifth to the sixth and so on to the nth dimension. And so you can throw away the ones with the least eigenvalue, and that's a way of saying that you're throwing away the projections or the directions or the features with the least amount of variance.